This week, the Sigma Alpha Epsilon fraternity is doing damage control after a video surfaced showing members of its University of Oklahoma chapter participating in a racist chant. SAE announced an initiative that includes appointing a diversity director, assembling a committee on inclusion, and requiring members to participate in a diversity education program. The fraternity's executive director said the incident has caused the organization to recognize its need to engage in a public dialogue about race.
We are committed to having the tough conversations in every chapter and with every member.
Joining the table now is Tracy Clayton, a staff writer at BuzzFeed.com and author of the story, A Black Girl's History with Southern Frat Racism. So this story got quite the buzz from BuzzFeed. Tell me just a little bit, for folks who haven't read it yet, what it's about.
Well, the essay is about my time at Transylvania University, which is in a real school that actually exists.
Yeah, there really is a Transylvania University.
First and foremost, it does exist. And I was there from 2000 to 2004. And it's just about what it's like to be a student of color on a campus where there are so many of the trappings of the Confederacy, which there were for a lot of different reasons. One was just sort of like school tradition. There's a dormitory that's still named after Davis, who was an alumni there. And there was also a fraternity that just had lots of Confederate flags just kind of hanging out on campus. And it's just about like what it was like to try to go to school and focus on school, but also feel really unsafe and unwelcome. And I like to say that my story is both common, but also not so common, because obviously not a lot of schools, I would hope, I guess I can't really provide proof of this, but I would hope that there aren't a bunch of Confederate flags on more campuses than not.
I have attended or taught at a lot of Southern universities. It is not uncommon, again, having grown up in the South. Now, I'm older than you, so I was coming through at a time, you know, I mean, like just early enough that, you know, our Kappa Alpha Order had Confederate flags, had Old South parties and that kind of thing in the early 90s when I was on campus. You know, part of what I thought was important here is that SAE, I do not want to be my Sherpa to race dialogue in the world, right? So I am distressed by it. On the other hand, as compared to the way that Transylvania University reacted to your BuzzFeed piece, which was there is at least appears to have been an email that went out to students that said, I just want to make each of you aware of an article that just came out on BuzzFeed referencing your article, and that the president, dean of students, and this person are all aware that it's out there. The president is determining how to address it. And at this time, we are asking you not to comment about the article on any social media platforms. So I don't really want SAE to talk, like, as a leader of the conversation, but I so prefer that over how don't you dare talk.
Right, exactly. And I feel like that's a very, very common reaction for any university to have, because, you know, your reputation is a big money getter for you, right? You know, you want people to think that you're a very, very great campus. And by the way, I do want to point out, Transylvania is a very, very good school.
Sure.
Education-wise. I met some beautiful, beautiful people there. However, there were a lot of things that were not handled the right way as far as listening to students when they say, hey, I don't feel safe.
Yep.
And this is a story that is specific to me or to Transylvania or Kentucky or the South, as the SAE video showed us. But, you know, this is about people, students of color on white campuses all over the place. And my hope, you know, it's kind of annoying to me to sort of champion the starting of conversations because, you know, after that conversation starts, that's real cool. But what do you do afterwards? But the biggest advantage that I feel that we can get from this story is finally being heard. Like my goal was not to make the school look bad. It was for me to be heard.
And that, to me, feels critical. And Amir, in fact, it feels to me like you actually give the school an opportunity in that moment. So the idea that let's not talk about it is the way to appear to be a great school, again, it's a college campus, right? So it seems to me another way to respond to it is, we have been challenged on this point. Let's talk about it. And that is how we will indicate how open we are, how willing we are to engage in dialogue and discourse, and how unafraid we are to be challenged.
Yeah, when we think about institutions and organizations, I think we have to pay attention to being more proactive than so reactive. Because if you're being proactive about these issues, when things like this come up, you have a lot to say. You have a lot to talk about to say, we're doing this, we're doing this, we're doing this. And it didn't work out here because these are challenging issues, but we have the things in place, we've been working on these things that position us to be able to have these conversations going forward.
That idea that maybe the race talk conversation starts not by asking how many friends you have, but asking about the questions of power and influence, I think is a critical one. Tracy Clayton, thank you so much
for
your piece. And up next,